Hello, my name is Sean, and I am at the Ed Noah Summer Camp, STEM Camp, and I am from Audubon Elementary in the fifth grade. And today, I'm going to be explaining about a double traffic light that you can make with the Arduino software. So, we have these cases that you can see that I organized with logic. So, you got four cases, okay, and you got two sets, A and B. So A will actually be one set on one side of the breadboard, and the other set will be on the other side of the breadboard. And we're going to be using the Arduino Uno for this. So we're going to be using the digital pins, and we're going to connect them to the breadboard, kind of like what you see here. And it's going to blink, but it's going to be at two times at the other side too. So what we do, we connect the digital pins of the Arduino Uno, and those are the pins right here, and connect them to the LED and the resistors, but we also have to code them, that way they work the same way as a car traffic light would do. So you would say like green would be on. Oh, and just to say that you also have to make sure that it's not going to be green and green because the two cars could crash, and also not yellow and green because the yellow, it's going to tell the cars to slow down or just go for it. So you need to wait for the cars to come to a complete stop. That way it would work the way it would and there would be no accidents. So we start off with G. The light would be on, the yellow light would be off, and the red light would be off. On the other set of the breadboard, G would be off, yellow would be off, and red would be on, telling the other side to stop because that side's gonna go. Second set. Set A is gonna be, okay, green is gonna be off, white is gonna be on, telling the people slow down because it's about to be a red light. Red is gonna be off. G will be off, Y will be off, and red would be on because it's still telling the people to stop. The other side. The third case we have here is that set A is going to be, G will be off. So set, cases 3 and 4 will be the inverse of 2 and 1. So A would be G, it would be off, Y would be off, and R would be on, telling that side would be to stop. Okay, B would be G, the green light would be on, Y would be off, and the red light would be off. For the last and final case, 4, A, set A says that G will be off, Y would be off, and R would be on, while B, it would be, G would be off, Y would be on, telling that side that the car should slow down or just go for it. It's about to be a red light. R would be off. And just that way, it continues on for the rest of the cars. It would loop infinitely. So if we go over here, this is what it looks like, the circuit. And if I plug it in to the Arduino code, IDE, you see that it would be red and green, red and yellow, green and red. Red and yellow, and it would keep on looping forever. And as you can see, there's no yellow or green or green or yellow, so which means no accidents would have occurred with this correct circuit that I made. And this is my code. So it tells that the setup is going to be these pin modes 13, 11, 9, 7, 5, and 3. It would be digital write, which tells it that the output will be 13 and it's going to be high, or it could also equal true, it could equal on, or it could equal false, or no, it could equal 1 in binary. And then also here, digital write 11, so it's coming out of 11, and it's low, so it could equal 0, it could equal false, it could equal off. And we made the sequence with all these pins, so the delay would be 7 seconds or 7,000 milliseconds.
could tell that the green light's gonna turn on, but also the red light is gonna be distributed in the code. So go down, and I wrote the same thing for it, each accounting for each case that we had on our logic table. And finally, if you run it, it's a correct circuit. There's nothing wrong with it. And yeah. And just if you're trying to build this at home, I would say, like, if you went back here, the code would be digital write, like whatever digital pin you would use, and you would do like high to low to low. And then digital write A to low and low and high. So you would say that the green light would be on for 7,000 milliseconds or 7 seconds. The yellow light would be on for 2,000 milliseconds or 2 seconds. And the red light would be on for 5 seconds or 5,000 milliseconds. And you remember, I organized it this line would separate the two parts of it. You could also cut the breadboard and like vertically, and you could do it one part like that. Remember about the digital pins. If it's not working, you would probably have made like a disconnection with the digital pins, or a disconnection with the wires on the breadboard, or maybe there's a bug that appeared in your code, or maybe you just did something incorrectly. The most common mistake, like how the challenges I faced, was mostly because of the code. Minor mistakes, such as like displace of the wires, could appear, but it's very minor. But the biggest challenge you have to face is probably like the code, because you have to be precise with the instructions in order for the computer to and the Arduino to work. So yeah, and so that's my traffic light, my deluxe traffic light display, and yeah. Could control things such as light and time and intensity, more things than a regular IC could do because of this microcontroller. So yeah, and thank you for watching.